Hey folks, in an earlier video, I walked you through the steps you need to set up and install the Microsoft Visual Studio C++ build tools, which are used on Microsoft Windows when you need to compile certain components for that platform. Today, I'm here to show you another simpler way to do the same thing. Instead of performing the setup through a graphic interface, I'm going to show you how to do the whole thing from a single command in the terminal. It's not just faster and more convenient, it's easier to share with others and easier to automate through scripting. Let's start with a scenario where I need Visual Studio's build tools in the first place. Now, I've shown off this example before. It's a Python program, a version of the cellular simulation Conway's Game of Life, and it involves a module that's written in Cython, which compiles to C. To compile that on Windows, I need the build tools. And right now, the build tools aren't installed. So if I try to run the setup process for this package, it's going to exit and it's going to give me this error. Now, in all fairness, if I go to the URL that they're providing here, I can get the build tools. But it takes several steps to set it up, not all of which are self-evident. There's a much simpler formula I can use from the command line. It requires that you have the Microsoft Winget package manager installed, which I've talked about separately. Winget is available by default in Windows 11, another good reason to upgrade. The command that we use installs the build tools through Winget, but it uses several options that are not specified by default. I'm going to step through these in detail because they explain why just installing the build tool package by itself won't work. So first, we have the command for the build tools package installation. Visual Studio 2022 is what we need to build for current versions of Python, so we'll use that version. Next comes the force command line switch, which ensures the command runs directly. It minimizes the amount of interaction that we have to perform with the process. The override switch changes the arguments that we're passing to the build tools installer itself. The arguments that follow in the quotes are everything that we send to the installer. Everything after this, in other words, is run by the build tools setup program. It's not run by Winget. So those options include wait. This ensures that the command that we're invoking through the setup process will wait until everything is finished before it returns control to the user. This is useful if you're scripting this process and you want to make sure everything unfolds in the proper order. Next, we have the passive switch. This forces the installer to run without user input. Again, useful for scripting. And then we have the add switch. This is where the magic is. This is how we add the needed build tools components to make the Visual Studio compiler work properly. And we can install what we need by way of a workload package. This gives us the basics for compiling with the Visual C compiler. And the include recommended option will bundle in things like the Windows SDK automatically. And we need those for this to work properly. Now, these are far from the only components that we could add in this fashion. Microsoft actually has a whole directory of such components. It's documented at this link. So if you're in need of adding other things automatically to Winget, you can consult this table and write a command line setup script using Winget and the installer to make that happen. For instance, if I had to install an earlier version of the Windows SDK, I could look that up here and supply the appropriate component ID. Now, when we run the setup process with this command line, the whole thing will take several minutes to execute. So when you do that, I recommend getting a cup of coffee. For the sake of speed, I'm actually going to just skip straight to the end of the install process, but you can guarantee that I've been letting it run in the background this entire time. So now that the installer is finished, let's restart Visual Studio Code and retry our setup process for this package. And as you can see, this time around, we don't have the setup complaining that there's no C compiler. Everything sets up and installs without an issue. And so we can run our program, complete with its compiled C module, also without issues. Again, the beauty of using Winget to do all this is we don't need to babysit the whole process. We can issue one command, either manually or as part of some larger automation process, and when we're done, we're ready to go. There's nothing to click through to. It's a huge boon, especially given how historically complex it's been to set up the Microsoft Visual Studio toolchain with a certain set of components. With this, you can just go and get on with the real work that you're trying to do. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.